a story begins, as many often do. The death of a king and the rise of a tyrant. The mother of the rightful heiress fleeing the kingdom to save her daughter. And a prophecy that on the 18th day of the 18th year of Alderaath, a hero would rise to reclaim a birthright stolen in blood. The child was borne away to the village of Kirkwall, a peaceful sanctuary on the western edge of the province of Ardenfell. It was the Spring Moon Festival, the 18th in fact since the death of the old king, and the village was celebrating as it always did. And, as always, there was one who was conspicuously absent. This is Elena. She always knew she was different. There was a longing in her heart that she could never quite give form to, and so she preferred adventuring in the forests around the village over the company of her peers. On the night of her 18th birthday, the spirit of the forest appeared to her in a sacred white oak and revealed who she really was. It bade her ride at dawn to reclaim her kingdom, for the appointed time had come. But to the east lay not merely a throne, but the very destiny of a princess and an empire.
Ryan Thomas at the EastWest here, and welcome to the official walkthrough for Hollywood Fantasy Wins, which is the next installment in our groundbreaking Hollywood Fantasy Orchestra series. Now, this one, I think, takes a bit of a turn more towards the lighter, more traditional fantasy. So think, you know, Chronicles of Narnia or How to Train Your Dragon. And it features five entirely new instruments that are just so incredibly stunning. They can really take you to a different world, especially in the context of the other fantasy orchestra libraries. Now, much like in the previous walkthroughs in this series, we're going to check out each individual instrument, but then we're going to break down the soundtrack that you heard at the beginning of this video and show you how Hollywood Fantasy Wins made it happen. So let's go ahead and dive right in. And we'll start with just a basic overview of the instruments and features. So you've got five main instrument groups: the high Irish whistles, low Irish whistles, Renaissance flutes, Uilleann pipes, and ocarinas. And these were all recorded in small ensembles, which makes this library quite unique. So you get this beautiful, lush presence, but the sound is still quite intimate. Now, just like the other Hollywood series instruments, you have a variety of mic positions to choose from, along with various moods, which change the mic mix, dynamic response curves, and internal reverb IR. So just to give you an idea of how these work, here's the low whistles in the soft mood. Here they are in the classic mood. And then the epic mood. So let's go ahead and check out the individual instruments. And we'll start in the high Irish whistles. And this instrument is just iconic fantasy. It's been featured in so many legendary fantasy soundtracks, like Lord of the Rings, of course, How to Train Your Dragon, and so many more. And you have your choice between a D and a B-flat whistle. And while they do sound similar, there are a few different nuances between them. So here is the D whistle. And then here is the B-flat whistle. So you can hear that the B-flat whistle has just a slightly rounder sound to it. So it might be a bit more ideal for a sonorous passage where you need something on the warmer side. Or if you need a whistle sound that's a little bit more focused and tight, the D whistle can really speak beautifully through a mix. Now, the low whistles just have this beautiful floating ethereal sound. So let's start with the D whistle, and we'll hear it in the soft mood. And I just love the timbre of the low E-flat whistles. I think they're just a little bit darker and warmer to my ear. Then you've got these really vibey staccatos. This is the finger vibrato. And then this is the western vibrato. So yeah, the low whistles just have such a magical, otherworldly sound. They're really ideal for fantasy when you just need to transport your listener. Okay, next up, let's check out the Renaissance flutes. And these just have such a beautiful warmth to them. They actually remind me a lot of an alto flute that's got just a little bit more color to it. These are, of course, made out of wood, and they're just really sonically interesting. So here is the legato. And you also have a variety of sustains, both with vibrato. And without vibrato. And then you have these really delicate staccatos. So just an exquisite lyrical sound. And next up, we have the Illan pipes. And these are the powerhouse of the library. They have an absolutely iconic sound. And these have been featured in legendary soundtracks like Titanic, Braveheart, How to Train Your Dragon, and of course, so many more. And the Illan pipes actually have three main sound sources. You've got the main drones, which you can find in these bottom keys here. Then you've got what are called regulators, which are basically like a more dynamic set of drones. So on a real set of pipes, you'd be able to change notes on these with some limitations. And then you have the chanter, which is going to play the melodic lines. And the Illan pipes can sound incredibly powerful. Let's go ahead and hear these in the epic mood. But these can also sound very emotional and evocative. So I'm gonna switch back to the classic mood and also switch between some of the other articulations to bring some additional color and emotion to this passage.
Thank you.
So just such an iconic sound. And finally, we have the ocarinas. And this is a very old instrument that was, of course, very famously reintroduced in modern culture by Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, which was a massive part of my childhood. And these have this breathtakingly soft and intimate quality that is both very emotional and also magical and mysterious. So here is the legato articulation. And just like with the other instruments that we've covered so far, you've got this beautiful palette of articulations like these accents. These really unique staccatos. You have these ascending glisses. Some flutters. And then these really beautiful, expressive sustains that I think work really well in a chord. So those are all of the instruments and most of the articulations. And they're just so magical. They really transport you to a different world. Very inspiring to play. So let's go ahead and watch the clip that we saw at the beginning of this video, but without any of the sound design or voiceover, so you can just hear the music by itself, and then we'll break down the soundtrack. Here it is. All right, so let's go ahead and just get right into this. And we'll start with the strings in the intro. And you've got these flautando violins coming in at the very beginning, along with these very light bass pizzicatos. And then this line here is the high strings from Hollywood Fantasy Strings, which consists of both violins and violas playing in octaves. And those are being supported by the low strings from Hollywood Fantasy Strings, which are celli and basses playing in octaves. So here is what the strings sound like by themselves. Those string ensembles from Hollywood Fantasy Strings are just so emotional and powerful. Then the brass is coming in around measure 5 to pretty much fill out that chord structure. So here is what that sounds like with the strings. And I just love the power of those Wagner tubas there. They really, I think, bring that whole section to life. Now, at the very beginning, before the brass comes in, you do have the orchestral woodwinds establishing the chord at the beginning of this intro, and they're also being joined by the ocarinas just to add a little bit of color. And you also have some light harp and tuned percussion content as well to kind of help drive things in this intro. So let's hear these elements by themselves. And finally, let's go ahead and add the Hollywood Fantasy Winds Irish whistle, which I've kind of saved for last year because it really helps to tie this whole section together. So I really like having that articulation palette available. You can just make lines so much more interesting and lifelike. So let's go ahead and move on to the next section. And most of this phrase is pretty much strings with just a little bit of harp, some brass here and there, and then, of course, Hollywood Fantasy Winds. So we wanted to keep the orchestration fairly light in this part because we're just telling a story and you don't want to overwhelm the voiceover. So the pizzicato basses are coming in at the start of this phrase, and then they transition to bass and cello sustains halfway through measure 9. And there isn't a whole lot of brass content in this part. You do have the Wagner tubas as well as a solo French horn coming in at measure 10, just to kind of crescendo a little bit into measure 11. And then you do have just a little bit of harp content playing very lightly in the background. That actually cuts out at measure 11, where you then have a women's choir coming in just to kind of warm things up and give it a little bit more emotion in this part. Now, Hollywood Fantasy Winds are actually going to be carrying the melody in both of these phrases. So in the first phrase, you have the low whistles, and then in the second phrase, you've got the Renaissance flutes coming in. So let's go ahead and just hear everything together since the orchestration here is so light. All right, so in this next phrase, obviously you heard those Illan pipes coming in. This is where the voiceover is talking about the prophecy, so the music needs to turn a bit darker and more mysterious. And so we're bringing in the Wagner tubas and the low brass to help sort of facilitate that change in the emotion here. And the low brass is basically doubling the low strings. So here's what the brass sounds like by itself. Now, here's what's going on in the strings. All right, and let's go ahead and solo the Illan pipes so that you can hear them by themselves. And I should point out that these vibrato sustains do have some built-in ornamentations, which is actually really desirable. You just get this really cool, authentic sound. Love how the vibrato develops on those. And again, those ornamentations are pretty much spot on. So let's go ahead and just hear everything together now. And And in this next section, we are being introduced to this beautiful, idyllic village. So the music is taking a much more positive, emotional turn. So we just needed some light fantasy music here, and the Irish whistles are going to be ideal for that. So you actually have a duet between the low and the high Irish whistles. So here's what they sound like together. And of course, a big part of achieving that realism there is switching up those articulations just to add more color and to make it interesting. Now, in the strings, you actually have quite a bit going on between the Hollywood Fantasy strings and the other orchestral strings. So at the very beginning, you just have this open fifth that's being played by the hardanger fiddles and the viola da gambas, and that sounds like this. And that was just really the perfect texture for this particular part. And then you have these being joined by the dulcimer, which is going to be providing movement for this part. And you also have some pizzicato basses. And finally, let's go ahead and hear all of the strings together. Now, you'll notice that this phrase starts off fairly sparse, and then as it progresses, as it evolves, we're adding more string instruments, and even the chord voicings are starting to expand. So just a reminder to always give yourself a place to build from. Now, there's not much brass in this section, but you do have this part coming in at measure 21, just because I really liked the chord progression there. It felt very emotional to me, so I kind of wanted to warm it up with some brass here. So the brass is just kind of helping to emphasize that moment. And then the only other element to speak of here are the crotales, and these are just adding some high-end sparkle in the second phrase. So let's go ahead and just unsolo everything and hear it all together. And in this next section, we're being introduced to the main character, and she's riding a horse, so we needed something very exciting and adventurous sounding. So the lead instrument here is going to be the high whistle doubled with the illan pipes, and it's a really, really cool doubling that sounds like this. And the Hollywood Fantasy wind instruments are being joined by both brass and string accompaniment here. So let's start with the strings. And the hardanger fiddles and the dulcimers are kind of helping to drive this section. And then you have some orchestral string shorts that are just punctuating the chords there. And then in the second half of this phrase, we actually transition to string sustains while still kind of keeping that groove in the dulcimers. So let's go ahead and hear the strings. All right, and then the brass is pretty much just mirroring what the strings are doing. You've got the brass shorts and then the brass sustains in the second half of that phrase. So here are the brass and the strings together. And then you pretty much just have this percussion from Hollywood Fantasy percussion, And that's pretty much the entire section. So let's go ahead and unsolo all of the elements so that you can hear everything together. Now, this next phrase is where things get more mysterious and magical because the spirit in the tree is revealing the main character's true identity and her destiny and all that. So this is going to be a perfect application for those ocarinas. So let's go ahead and hear them by themselves. Now, in the context of the full mix, you aren't going to be hearing these distinctly. They're meant to blend in as a texture with everything else to just create this magical, mystical atmosphere. Now, in the strings, you do have some tremolo violas here. And then everything else is going to be legato sustains. So let's hear the strings and the ocarinas. Then in the percussion, you have these crotales coming in, and they're really going to help this section feel very magical and ethereal. And you also have these woodwind staccatos that are also just going to help this section float. So they sound like this together. So that's a big part of the feel in this section. And then you have these harp and tuned percussion elements as well. And you also have some vocals in this part. And then in this second phrase at 40, we're bringing in the full brass section to crescendo into the next part. And let's go ahead and hear everything together. All right, and then this next section is kind of the big climax. So we have this big run going up to the main theme. So let's go ahead and get into that. And we'll start with the strings. And the writing here is fairly simple. You just have this big run going up to the main theme, starting at 46 with the violins and the violas on melody, and also violins and violas on this ostinato line with the basses and the celli playing this bass line. And then at the very end, the strings are pretty much just holding out those notes while the Hollywood Fantasy Winds are playing these, you know, little bits and snippets of that same melody just to kind of play us out. So here are all the strings together. And now here are the strings and brass together. So you can hear the brass here is mostly defining the chord, and then the strings are just playing ostinato lines and melodies, and also that bass line, of course. And then here's what the percussion and tuned percussion is doing. And it pretty much just goes on like that. So not too much to talk about there. And then you do have the woodwinds that are also doubling those string ostinatos. And again, they just kind of go on like that. And finally, we do have some vocals as well. And now let's go ahead and hear the orchestra together with the Hollywood Fantasy wind instruments. And these are really just going to bring the melody to life. So you've got the high Irish whistles and the Illan pipes joining the high strings on that melody. So here is everything together. So that is Hollywood Fantasy Winds. And, you know, the reason we do these walkthroughs like this is because I think hearing the instruments in isolation is really only half of the story. I think it's so valuable to be able to see how these instruments can work together, especially in the context of the other Hollywood Fantasy Orchestra libraries. So, of course, Hollywood Fantasy Winds is available as a standalone purchase, or it also just comes with a Composer Cloud Plus subscription. So it's just really incredible value there. And if you liked this video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any future content. That's all for now. Thanks so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.